Today we're going to take a little break from our tailwheel training and do some expanded envelope exercises. Jocelyn is a newly minted private pilot, and the skills she demonstrated to get that ticket are still quite sharp. The goal today is to get Jocelyn comfortable maneuvering the airplane in places and in ways that are currently outside her comfort zone. Jocelyn's getting pretty good at tailwheel takeoffs. I want Jocelyn to become comfortable and confident in her ability to maneuver the airplane at lower altitudes. We're going to follow the twists and turns of the Hall River toward Jordan Lake at 500 feet. We are at cruise power doing 100 knots, so there's absolutely no chance of stalling during any of the turns. I'm handing Jocelyn a post-it note to cover the altimeter. This puts her in a very uncomfortable position, but in reality, the altimeter is pretty much useless down here because the elevation terrain changes, so flying at constant barometric altitude really may not be the safest thing to do. You want to use your eyes to judge your altitude as you fly down the river, scanning frequently for obstacles. Any obstacle that pokes above the horizon is an obstacle you can hit. If the obstacle does not poke above the horizon, you will not hit the obstacle. Making a U-turn here, using a medium bank turn. Jocelyn is not comfortable doing this without the altimeter, so the post-it note has been removed from the altimeter. Hopefully in the future, with some more training, she will be totally comfortable making this turn just by looking outside the airplane. Next, we'll climb up to 4,500 feet for some maneuvers. At this altitude, Jocelyn's quite comfortable with steep turns. I think one of the factors in fear of stalls is the feeling that you're falling and you're not in control of the airplane. So I have a maneuver I call a roller coaster where we take the airplane up almost to a stall, but not into the stall, and then we push the nose over, gain airspeed again, then pull the nose back up and push over again. This gives about a half a G loading at the top where we do a pushover, and a little over a G at the bottom, pulling back up again. I basically want my student to get comfortable with that feeling of less than one G. Ultimately, I'd like to get to zero G. Right now, on these maneuvers you see here, we're getting to about a half a G. The next maneuver, we're going to add a full left aileron to the top of our roller coaster, and we're going to do what's called an aileron roll, or a ballistic roll. You can see we're in a bit of a dive after that maneuver. We can reduce that dive by raising the nose a little bit more when we enter the roll, and getting to zero G by pushing forward on the stick. Right now we're still at about a plus half a G, so the wing is actually pulling the nose down or upside down. I'm going to demonstrate that by pushing forward on the stick while inverted in the roll, you can eliminate the dive as you come out of the roll. Now that one was excellent. Jocelyn pushed forward on the stick to 0G, and we weren't in quite the dive when we came out of the maneuver. Most private pilots are terrified at the thought of a spin. I want to show Jocelyn just how easy it is to stop a spin almost before it starts. So we're going to pull the nose way up to a power on stall. I'm going to kick the rudder hard to the left, and then that puts us in a spin, and then I'm going to immediately recover. We actually only did a half a turn in that spin. Jocelyn asked that we do another spin, so this time we will do a full turn, just a one turn spin, and then recover. Nose is coming up, do a full stall with some power. And I'll hit a left rudder here, and over it goes, and go around, and hit opposite rudder, forward stick to break the stall, and just pull out of the dive. The real bad part of a spin is the visual. There really is much less to it than meets the eye. It's my hope that Jocelyn will continue training and learn how to do the spins on her own. The decathlon has no flaps, so you really need to be skillful in slipping the airplane during a landing. I noticed that Jocelyn gets a little nervous when we are aggressively slipping the decathlon down to a landing. So what we're going to do is slip the airplane really hard at altitude, and we're going to stall it while we're doing the slip. And as Jocelyn sees, the airplane is quite well behaved, even in the stall during the slip. The wing does not drop, it just buffets while it's slipping down. Well, I think that's enough fun for one day.